So, a lot of things went wrong on my turn. Where to begin?
Dice gods
Well,
hate you.
yeah, my the dice gods hate me. I said some bad things when I thought they weren't listening. And so, what happened first is the Woldweird. He did teleport behind the Nomad. Unfortunately, he missed with one of his attacks. He needed threes to hit, he rolled a two. So therefore his chain smite did not go off. That was bad. He managed to do some damage to him with his other attacks, but not a lot. Maybe about a quarter to a third of his health. So then that left me with a mangler in the middle of all my stuff, and that needed to go. So I brought Megalith over. Megalith came over, and unfortunately, he could not use Geomancy on himself to give himself the plus two strength from Stone Skin because he was within 10 inches of. What's the evil wizard?
Midwinter.
Midwinter was there, and so he was only dishing out his POW 16s. And he took him down to about three quarters health, but still not dead, and the blood trackers are still tied up. So the Woldweird activated, and since he had upkeeps on him, decided to take a pot shot and brought him down to about 6 points of health. Made a second shot, brought him down to 1 point of health. So finally, my druid stone sprayed him and crit knocked him down, but didn't kill him, but knocked him down. So then the blood trackers activated, shifted to the flank. One of them javelined the knockdown mangler, killed him. And then six of them threw javelins at the renegade on this left flank and did a decent amount of damage, but not as much as I would like. So on the renegade to the far flank, I decided to tie him up with some mannequins. And since I had one fury on the sentry stone, I boosted an attack damage roll into his back and actually did about 6 points of damage there. And then did a few more bits of damage with the second attack to his back. And so I think I did around 8 or 9 points of damage, probably around eight. The one to the front did nothing, but he's tied up. He's also not within his command range to get focus. So Baldur also popped his feet. I don't know if you can see him, but he's hiding behind the druid's cape in a very epic pose. I'm pretty safe, but I was hoping to do a lot more damage that turn. So now let us see what the counterattack brings. Well, as expected, the counterattack was pretty muted because of Baldur's feet and just the positioning of the models, although he still was able to do a little bit of damage. The renegade attempted to move out of combat to shoot at Baldur. But unfortunately, a free strike from one of the mannequins managed to damage his rocket, and realizing that he would not be able to do anything with it, he decided to chainsaw the sentry stone and do a point of damage to it. The nomad took a swing at Megalith and did 8 points of damage, and then bucklered one of the blood trackers. Two more blood trackers died when Magnus shifted sideways and sprayed them, and boosting a hit killed both of them. And Meg, with an attack that was just within range, shot one of the forward mannequins. For my turn, I don't think I'm going to be going for assassination. More likely, I'll be just attempting to clean up and consolidate my lead. I don't want to risk doing anything drastic and bad that puts my caster in a bad situation when there's no need to. When I'm this far ahead, I can pretty easily take care of his heavy jacks and he won't really have anything to deal with it, and he'll just be running around with a caster. So let's see what happens. So things are kind of winding down now. Like I said, I just decided to consolidate my turn. Simply, Baldur moved over this direction to cast Stone Skin on the blood trackers and to also take it off the World Warden. I'll explain that in a moment. They then went to town on the poor renegade and butchered him. They chose Magnus as the next prey, but since he has blur and he's in a forest, they missed. the mannequins managed to kill off the renegade they're working on over there. Mr. Megalith decided to use his animus and then charge the Nomad, getting the Nomad and Magnus within 5 inches to make them -2 defense to help. And then Megalith killed the Nomad because he hits like a freight train. Then the World Warden, since he didn't have Stone Skin anymore, he can now charges for free because of Balder, charged Magnus. Unfortunately, didn't roll too well on my damage, did about 6 or 7 points of damage, but now Magnus is engaged with a very angry World Warden who is undamaged. So now let's see if Lost Blue can find a way out of this mess. So, on Lost Blue's last turn, he decided to valiantly charge forward with his remaining forces. The mule valiantly hit the World Warden in the back for some damage, and it hurt. But, unfortunately, Meg failed her drive check, so he wasn't getting any bonuses. Once again, what's the evil wizard's name?
Midwinter.
Midwinter zapped the World Warden to then have the lightning bounce to his caster, Magnus, and then bounced to kill a blood tracker that was in the way. Nothing got damaged except, of course, the blood tracker. And then finally, Magnus charged through the gap, survived a free strike from the World Warden to attack Megalith, but realizing that Megalith still had about a third of his health left when he was done, decided to concede the game since he is surrounded by my army. So, thank you very much. I hope you guys enjoyed that. We are going to do a little after-battle report talk, so hold on a moment for that.